Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Buonasera, signore e signore. I'm really sorry not to be able to be there. Unfortunately, the dates did not work out all right. Mi spiace che non posso essere lì di persona. Mi avrebbe fatto veramente tantissimo piacere essere lì insieme a tutti voi. E naturalmente in particolare, I would have been delighted to be there to share some of the comments and participate in a conversation with my great friend Don Tullio. And with Dr. Ferrario as well. I'm sure that their testimonials, their stories, their talks will stir great impetus and great commitment to all of you. And of course, Don Tullio, I've had the pleasure of working with for a while. And speaking of that, on the topic that you're talking about today, the importance of hope. Hope is a therapeutic agent, better than many of the therapy agents that we have. A therapy agent that has been known throughout humankind, the history of humankind. But that now, because the world has turned quantitative, we are trying to reposition by quantifying it in ways that are in keeping with the modern way in which therapies are taken to the clinic. But it's something that we always known about and that nobody would ever doubt. But it behooves us to place it on firm scientific foundations and to incorporate it in the most efficient fashion into our clinical practices. We do evidence-based medicine these days, and that's a good thing. So we need to be able to do that for everything that supports the human soul and brings hope. So back to Don Tullio. Don Tullio, unfortunately, will be leaving us. After his period as a visiting scholar here at Houston Methodist, this is the second time he's been with us, and every time he has left a great trail of hope, no pun intended, and of science, so hope in medicine, and great enthusiasm in all of us. Once, on several occasions, I actually went to visit him at the Istituto Nazionale di Tumori in Milan, the National Cancer Institute of Italy, where he is the chaplain. And as part of some of those visits, we actually even got a publication out of that. Very proud to have my name in the same booklet as that Dr. Father Tullio is an author in, even though this has created a little bit of discomfort, let me tell you. Once I received it, I noticed with great consternation that if you look at the list of authors, somehow, whoever picked it put my name first in front of the name of the Minister of Health of Italy, in front of the name of the governor of the region of Lombardy. So that was a little bit embarrassing. And I thought when I saw this, I said, Father Tullio, how could you do this to me? And then I realized that it wasn't him. I don't know who did this, but do you know how I found out? If you look at the list, the name of Father Tullio is there right before the name of Cardinal Scola, at which point I realized that it could have possibly been Father Tullio. But with this little tongue-in-cheek observation, just for fun, I am hoping to bring a little bit of levity to this great meeting that you're having. I want to close by my short greetings. Wishing you, of course, the best for this encounter and that the very best outcomes may come out with the Lord's blessing that can help others have hope, that we can have hope, that we can have hope. It's a contagious disease that hopefully you'll be able to spread to everybody that needs it. So God bless you, Signore vi benedica. Arrivederci e buon lavoro.